Welcome back to New Rockstars. I'm Eric Voss, and Marvel's Eternals sets itself apart from the MCU with stunning visuals. But because it's an MCU movie, of course, it has an uncanny obsession with Captain America's shield, something I thought only weirdos like us have. This trailer ended with a shout out to Captain Rogers, and in my breakdown, I found at least three different shields matching the designs of versions of Cap's shield we've seen before. So let's dive into what this shield connection is all about and what it tells us about where the Eternals have been all this time. Now, of course, the Eternals are a group of ageless godlike protectors created by the Marvel gods, the Celestials. And this trailer ends with the Eternals speculating about the post-endgame status of Earth's more famous lineup.
So now that Captain Rogers and Iron Man are both gone, who do you think's gonna lead the Avengers?
Calling Steve Captain Rogers is a bit of a choice. Like, you could just see it as Sprite keeping tabs on the fact that Captain America is now a designation carried by Sam Wilson, meaning her Disney Plus subscription is up to date, or really she's just sharing Gilgamesh's login. But really, Captain Rogers just sounds like what he was called before the title of Captain America came to mean something more than a campy propaganda tool. It was something people who knew him from the 1940s might call him. And note how Sprite's eyeline on that question was to Kingo, and it's Kingo who is the first to burst into laughter when Icarus volunteers himself to lead the Avengers. That might be because Kingo seems to be a huge Captain America fanboy. On his private jet, you can see Cap's original shield, the one that he carried in World War II. It's either a replica of the one that's supposed to be in the Smithsonian, or since the Eternals seem to possess a trove of priceless artifacts, including other stuff supposed to be in museums, and the freaking Holy Grail, this shield might be the real thing. Similarly, it looks like Kingo has worked in Cap's shield into his Bollywood films, because in the background, you can make out four guards carrying rounded shields that seem to have the central star and concentric stripes of Cap's shield design. Actually, this same shield can be seen way more clearly earlier in the trailer, held by a warrior. Now, that warrior's look and the whole setting just makes me think this could be part of the Eternals' liberation of Babylon in ancient times. So, did Captain America's stars and stripes design actually date back to ancient Mesopotamia? I mean, the implication of Cap's original look in that first Cap film, when Howard Stark gave him that vibranium shield, was that this was all just a suggestion by Steve, an upgrade from his patriotic USO costume.
I had some ideas about the uniform.
Now, I guess you could say there are other explanations, like maybe this scene in the Blue Room could be taking place in the modern era, or at least post-1945, and Thena is just fighting a LARPer. Or maybe that shield design could just be a coincidence or a set designer Easter egg. You know, they don't always think too much about the logical implications of this stuff. Or some time travel explanation, like the Eternals themselves are unstuck in time, but they just use that power for hilariously basic stuff, like giving their past selves ideas for cosmetic designs on shields. Actually, let me write that down for a future video idea. Okay. Great, no one will watch that one. The possibility I am most interested in is the character Phastos, Brian Tyree Henry, the great engineer of the Eternals, who, along with Ajak and Cersei, have helped humanity with advancements in agriculture, technology, and medicine. The basic idea is that all the seemingly miraculous technological discoveries mankind has made, Phastos has been in the background being like, try plugging that into that. In this trailer, we hear the words of Ajak.
We have watched. Unguided, we have helped them progress. Throughout the years, we have never interfered.
A statement that seems a bit self-contradictory, right? Like, how can you help humanity progress with these cheat codes, yet not consider that to be interference? Actually, I assume that will be the argument of Drigg, who seems to be living with a brainwashed cult in a camp off the grid. But I think what this means is, yeah, the Eternals aiding humanity is a hypocritical overreach of their non-interventionalist approach. And that inner conflict has defined the Eternals' existence as they have struggled to find a loophole to help humans figure things out on their own. And I think they finally found an answer in the 1940s with the Super Soldier Program, with SHIELD, and with the eventual outgrowth of those things, the Avengers. But before I continue, this video is sponsored by Sheath underwear. Sheath's boxers are designed to keep your bits gently separated for maximum comfort. Sheath has three individual compartments to keep everything down there separate, cool, and most importantly, comfortable. The design of traditional boxer briefs can make all your different parts stick together and sweat and then start to chafe. While Sheath has a modern ergonomic design intended to prevent skin-on-skin contact. See, they've got this inverted kangaroo pouch for your Joey to cut down on chafing and readjusting. You got one pouch here, another pouch for that guy. And then everybody's hanging out, having a good time. Because, you know, when you gotta readjust, it's never a really great look unless you play professional baseball. And, you know, even then, come on. So sheath were invented by a U.S. Army soldier who came up with the idea for sheath during a second tour in Iraq, where that super hot climate prompted some serious discomfort for the unmentionables. So click the link below and use the code NEWROCKSTARS at checkout, or go to sheathunderwear.com/newrockstars for 20% off and do your boys a favor. That's sheathunderwear.com, or just click the link below and use the code NEWROCKSTARS for 20% off. While the stars and stripes design of this shield seem to come from the Star Spangled Man with a Plan, its construction remains a mystery, with Howard Stark forging it from vibranium, despite knowing nothing about what's supposed to be the world's only source of vibranium, the giant meteor formed Mount Bashenga in Wakanda.
What about this one?
No, that's just a prototype.
What's it made of?
Vibranium. That's the rarest metal on Earth. What you're holding there? That's all we've got.
So Howard Stark must have gotten that vibranium from somewhere or from someone, and I think that mystery source could have been Phastos, posing as an engineer working alongside Howard on that team. And when Howard gets Steve's design wish list, he turns to his guy and says, "Hey, you're the one who found all this rare metal. How the hell are you gonna stick paint to it?" And then Phastos just goes, "Hey, I got a design that's worked for me before," and actually lines up with what Cap is going for. Similarly, if you think about this, Dr. Erskine's Super Soldier Serum was a mystery cocktail that was upgraded from the serum used by Red Skull, something many others tried to replicate until recently became the central focus of the Falcon and the Winter Soldier. We never knew what that missing ingredient was that made it different from the one that Red Skull took, and I think Erskine could have been supplied some herbal medicinal ingredient by Ajak, the Great Healer, also posing as a SHIELD scientist alongside Phastos. Remember, in the trailer, her tank of plants contains something of a teal color, which matches the color of the Super Soldier Serum. That, right there, could be the missing ingredient that made the serum that Steve took miraculously work, finally. I think the Eternals' goal has been to give humanity a superhuman protector so that they could step back and let mankind avenge itself. That's why they're such big fans of Captain Rogers. It's because he and his buddies have been taking care of business, like a teen who just got his driver's license driving their drunk parents home. Teen DD right here. But now those days are over. Captain Rogers and Tony Stark, the son of the engineer Phastos inspired, are both gone. They gave their lives to take out Thanos, who, like Cersei and the rest of the Eternals, was an Eternal himself. He had a deviant gene, but he was an Eternal. And remember, Thanos was a farmer, an environmentalist, obsessed with everyone having enough natural resources. Really just a terrorist extreme of what other Eternals like Cersei, Ajak, and Phastos have always strived for. So Thanos' mission to cull half of all life for the benefit of the other half could have been a mission sanctioned by the Celestials, similar to how in the Infinity Gauntlet comics, Thanos was found not guilty by the Living Tribunal, who ruled that his snap did not violate any natural laws. And if you think about it, the MCU Celestials that we've met, Ego, Eson the Searcher, they seem to be pretty amoral a-holes. But now, when the Eternals' replacements stop Thanos from carrying out that population control, the Celestials might be returning to Earth to have a word with their Eternal creations and terminate their position, aka this planet, setting up a pretty high-stakes battle for the end of the world. Ow, demonetization. To support this channel, check out one of our great merch options at newrockstarsmerch.com. Follow me on Instagram and Twitter at EAVoss. Follow New Rockstars. Subscribe to New Rockstars for more analysis and breakdowns of everything Marvel. Thanks for watching. Bye.